Comrades, we are here looking at our construction supply buildings. It's very good to see them churning out at least a little bit of black smoke over there, right? So we are making some bricks, and you know, let's go ahead and turn on this HUD because I can't see my mouse. It'd be nice if they could leave the mouse going with the rest of the HUD off, but I understand it's all good. So there we go. So we have plenty of people, and really almost no time has passed since the last episode. I mean, real life it has, but it's the next day since I recorded. And what I would like to do is relatively quickly get going on supplying these things to the rest of the map. And, you know, I started building on more of this stuff. I think mostly these roads, which is okay. But I was thinking about this. We really don't need, like, in the long run, I would like to have a train that does the exporting, right? And when we have the train, I think we would need more of these kind of things. And for now, though, I think we could get away with just having one of these. And I think I'm not sure that it makes too much difference. You know, maybe this one's a little better if we can do it. But can we get a road cargo station? I know these have been popular for us to build. No, well, maybe. Let me see, the old one. Right, will you fit in there? Nah, that's... I could probably try to go on the other side of those railroad tracks, which in some way doesn't break my heart, but I think that's going to be... I think that's going to be too far away, right? Over... you know what? That might not... that might not be too bad, actually. But you know what? There's probably something else we should consider doing. Now, this is sort of a problem. I was hoping... Yeah, let's just get rid of this for a second. Now, is there... I mean, this one could be better to do at the end of this road, right? Is that... I think we could maybe do it here. Now, we could also do, like, maybe a... Yeah, I like the old one. I will never get rid of that hotbar thing, right? Yeah, then that's sort of getting up into the way of our railroad tracks a bit. Maybe I do like the new one for this. All right, because we can do... Yeah, I don't know if it's going to make that turn. Maybe too tight. Some other infrastructure's in the way. It's probably this road. Yeah, this is getting to be a bit of a pain. Yeah, that's not the right type over there. We can't use that one. So, all right, we'll figure out a spot for it. Even if we have to take down every tree in the neighborhood, right? Yeah, can we see? This is... Yeah, I don't even know that that's really going to work either, right? Like, if I could come off here, but see, we're just a little bit too... All right, let's get rid of some power line. I'm just going to pause it for a minute so I don't grind everything to a halt. And I want to come over here, and I want to try to see if I can't put that guy right there. So we're just going to delete that and that and that for now. Road cargo station. I think I'm going to go with the old one that I have on here. All right, just kind of see if that won't work. Too sharp of a turn. Then it's going to go and tell me that's the new one. Let's go. Maybe too sharp of a turn. No. Right, that's not so bad. So then now we need to get a road before we start worrying about... And then the other thing is we really want to start upgrading these things. Is it's probably, even though we don't have a lot of money, since we've already busted that apart, it is probably worth, let's see, this might be an argument, I'm sorry, it is probably worth just replacing that and paying for it, because I don't want to leave the power down over to here until we get some kind of a duplicate system going. And by that I mean like a system where we can feed in from two different directions and build the power lines at our leisure. So what I'm wondering here is, would it be beneficial to like come off of here. Right, but then do we also come off of there, or is that just kind of craziness? I mean, it's only a gravel road at the end of the day, right? Like if we came off of here. Let's get rid of that. Right, it looks kind of cool. It's a little off-centered. But then if they come in this way, can they go back out that way? Does it work like that? Because, you know, like I'm picturing them coming from dropping off stuff down that way, and then they come in, they drop it off, and then they drive back out here to go over to get to their respective whatever it is, or they can just come right back. We might even want a road from here to there, huh? Yeah, and that might make some sense too. Yeah, let's do that. All right, so we're going to do... Do the zoom in thing, right? And then let's get rid of this for the moment. And then we're gonna come down to there, right? So I don't like that that's two separate projects. So let's get rid of that. Hopefully nothing burns down in the meantime, right? Yeah, and so you can go there. We could talk about that road in the future. All right, so there. So we'll commit to those. So that's sort of a lot of road building for this, but I think it'll help a tiny bit with the efficiency. Now, we can also pick things up from here. So one of the things we could probably do right off the bat is start. Let's get... Well, we need to get this built first, don't we? Yeah, never mind. All right, let's get this built first, and then we can set this, and then we can start taking everything but the steel out of here, right? And just get it driven over to there. Let's do the power line thing. All right, so we're going to cancel wires, and just we're going to bite the bullet and pay for this to be upgraded to... Right, so we're just going to upgrade this to the medium ones. Can we go from A to B? No. Now, is there going to be a better way to do this? Like, can we go... Yeah, you know what? That's... I mean, assuming this doesn't get in the way in 10 minutes, I kind of like that, because if I want to build anything else, I'm probably a little more likely to want to build it up by the road there. Right, so let's commit to that. Well, yeah, let's just commit to it, and then I'll select it. And we're gonna 17 grand, and yeah, it's gonna hurt a little bit, but all right, there we go. So we'll have that back, and power will get instantly back. And then the good news is now we're upgraded with the slightly bigger lines. We would just need to get like this stretch upgraded right here, and then we'll have bigger power over there. Now, another thing, speaking of power, that we should probably consider is getting big power lines out of here, right? And over to the rest of the map. I'm not sure, I haven't really looked, but we're going to need to do that, you know, rather sooner, I guess you could say. And then, here, we definitely want to get this built. Let's get this committed to so it's not white. And then we can get these guys. What are they doing? Just roads for the moment. Yeah, let's get them. They can start working on this. And then this. And then this. And then that. Right. And then, well, we'll hold off on that other one. So that'll give them plenty to do. Now, we could start, even though we don't have our export thing. I want to build this before we get too much going here. But I think I'd like to talk about and just kind of take a look out of the cloud view here. You know, I definitely want to build over this way. And I'm really thinking that a bigger supply, like along the riverbank, someplace we could actually maybe even start supplying and or exporting some of this stuff and put it on a ship, or, you know, like, because Eggenham will expand here, but I don't know that, You know, like, in other words, having this over here was nice to be able to purchase things in the very beginning. And it would be a nice little supply depot, but I'm thinking of a bigger supply. You know, I'm kind of liking the idea of maybe over here. I'm just considering, should we put it on this side near Eggenham? But no, probably not. Now, if we build another bridge, here's another thing. I don't know the answer to this question. If anybody can answer it, I'd really appreciate it. Otherwise, I'm going to have to go do homework or maybe even some experimenting. If I build a bridge across here, am I going to cut off? Like, if we look at our map, right? Get big, right? We're right here. Now, this part here, I guess we could maybe lower this. I'm not sure why he did it this way, or, you know, it seems to me that that's, like, I'm not sure why this is, like that. In other words, like, why isn't it open? But the fact is, if I build across here, I've already built across right there, which is here. If I build across this, it's going to block all of this. Now, does that matter? Can they just still go out this way? And really, I care more about the NATO, but are we not going to be able to get over the bridges, I guess, is the point, right? And that's just it. I'd really like to know if I can get over those bridges. It's like, in other words, let's get out of the clouds. Like, you know, I could build a bridge right across here to here, but I don't want to block the whole thing. And then if I build a bridge from here to here, it's going to block the whole thing, right? Now, part of our problem is getting power across that whole thing, but I know we could probably do it here. So the question is kind of important because, well, it's really pointing to, if I were going to build a bridge across here to get over to this spot, which would really be kind of nice, right? Because there's not too much of a possibility of putting a city there, but it might make a nice launching point. So with this, right, either one of those would make a nice launching point over to here as far as the, you know, just building for the future goes. But that would matter where I put my, you know, supply. Like, coming here is kind of safe because we already got that bridge, and then we just go to here. And I'm kind of picturing this might be a nice place for a, you know, bit of a city kind of thing. I don't think there's anything going on this island that's that spectacular. You know, I mean, if we, you know, but it could certainly, it's a nice central big island. I mean, we could always smooth out the water if it particularly got in our way as far as that goes. So this, certainly you could argue that this might be a good place for a bigger supply. Yeah, I mean, maybe that is the better place. Now, where do we look at, like, if we look at the map again? Yeah, this is really pretty central, but it's not central to building down here. But it would be pretty central to getting everything else up here built, right? Because this is the edge of the map right there. So that, like, pushing into the, like, where we're at here really would get us, you know, the ability to then distribute it out either way here. But then again, we could do it just as easily right there, right? And be on the right side of the river. So that's part of the debate. And then as far as this goes, yeah, this is kind of screaming out, maybe we put a little bit bigger supply here and then another one of these places. I'm kind of liking, and this is why I keep looking at this, but I don't know if it's going to block. You know, I would definitely be willing to build a bridge right here across the river and then put the supply depot here where I'm really not that likely to build an actual city, right? It's just more just going to be like supply distribution where we would then have, sorry, spinning around too much, make you guys seasick. We would then have something like this, or we just have a little thing that we could, you know, fill up for the purposes of their local construction. So yeah, I think I've just convinced myself that we would come to here and maybe design, you know, like, and by the way, this would ultimately be like a place we would have trains. Like, so our train lines would come around and down into here, and then supply this bigger depot with by train. All right, so I did like my ladder setup that we had before as far as that goes. But yeah, we could set up like what I would call just a regular construction supply depot over here, which would be very similar in some ways to this. And the reason I'm saying all of that is, you know, here's our train tracks. We would come bring them in and probably, yeah, keep them on this side of all of that mess, right? So they would probably kind of go right through Lykov's house to some degree. Let's start plopping them in, right? If they came in here or something like that, right? We'd have a double track coming in. And then that track would eventually need to get back out of here. And would it go right across the river? That sort of makes a lot of sense. Either that or it would turn up the river and then cross over here and go to there, right? So we'll leave it so that there's plenty of room. Yeah, to go past Eggenham here, right? So this would be, let's just do something like, you know, let's get it so it's kind of straight with the river this way. All right, so just in case we wanted to come back and go across the river, that would be the way the tracks would go there. So we'd have some kind of a big intersection here if we needed it. So I wouldn't want to get too close up into this, right? That power line is really kind of right to some degree across where I'd want to go. I'd want to stay kind of close to this road for the sake of, yeah, let's just do this. See what that looks like. Oh, that's not the thing I wanted to do. See, I missed. Right, and then this one would come that, right? So that's how they could cross. And then that keeps it a little, like turned it a little bit in. Yeah, these, well, I wonder if we could work around the power lines. We're getting low on money. So I'm doing all this, is just so you know, to kind of kill some time too, right? We're together. We're playing on the map. Let's go see. Do we have any, no plus 21s. School people are happy. Let's go check this town real quick because, yeah, so keeping the total number of people, but their happiness, you know, kind of coming up. Yeah, you know, not too many people. Never too many people in the hospital. Good. Kindergarten's doing well. Not too many older students. And again, let's let everything settle down, right? So, and then the university. Yeah, good. We're teaching lots of university educated. Okay, so we seem to be in pretty good shape over here. And, right, yeah, I think everywhere. So how are we doing on our building the roads? Well, we're getting stuff. Are we having any issues here? No. Let's go check on our other little construction. I don't think we actually checked him earlier. Good. So he's still building that, and he's still building this. And, yeah, we just need more. That's all right, though. He's getting the roads done, right? Because this is actually, you know, sometimes I think I go through these episodes, and we don't really talk about things episode to episode, but this is really my highest priority at this point because I think we can up the amount of income. We need to get more income. You know, like I had comments saying that I was fussing over the price. And I really wasn't fussing. I was discussing, in my own opinion, the whether we do this with electrical rails or not to get started. And I understand, believe me, the benefits of going straight with electrical. Right now, considering we're making most of all of these, we're making our own gravel, the prefab panels, you know, eventually we'll even get our own cement going for that. But, you know, really, you know, that's relatively cheap. And the steel is going to be relatively cheap. Well, if we electrify these, now we're talking about spending in the neighborhood of 20, at this point in what things cost, it's 25% more than if we paid for the steel and the other things, right? So like right now we would pay like almost nothing for this rail, but if we electrify it, we'll pay tens of thousands of dollars for all these rails, right? I mean, you're talking about hundreds of thousands of more dollars. And then when we're making, well, let's say, let's go to last month, right? Now some of this might have been construction related stuff, but probably pretty limited. Yeah, that's the gravel, probably when I was messing around with these things here, I bet. When we're still buying some power, which is sort of a bit of an issue, or we did. Are we still doing it now? No, we got rid of that. So we can count that out. So that's, you know, maybe 6,000 we could add to. Chemicals are going to be a normal purchase for us. Fuel, probably until we get that going, is going to be a normal purchase. So let's go back and look at last month. You know, we made 30 grand. And the problem is we have Well, 1,100, million, I'm sorry, 1.1 million in debt. I mean, it would take us a long time just to pay this debt off if we don't increase things. And so to go and spend a bunch of money on high speed rail that really or electrified rail that's really not going to pay anything back, right? Like, in other words, whether this rail is regular rail or not, like, the benefit of the electric rail is just almost nothing in a sense. I mean, believe me, I understand that there is a benefit to it. I'm not saying it's nothing, but it's not going to necessarily bring us any more money into our economy, right? Certainly nothing significant. So that's the factor. Do we spend all this money on the electrified rail that we don't have to spend if we just build the regular rail, right? And considering how little money we actually have, that's why I'm fussing. It's not a matter of is it worth it? It's like, is it worth it right now, considering our pretty dire financial straits, to be honest with you. So we'll see. I really do. It's a debate for me. It's if I'm fussing, it's because it's a debate whether it's worth it to spend. I don't know how much. If we want to talk about all of these rails, we're probably talking about at least 10 kilometers of rail that I just have designed here, and here. So you're talking about 200,000. Yeah, I mean, is that probably worth it in the long run? In the long run, absolutely. In the short run, we don't have any money. I certainly don't want to go into more debt to build these extra electrical rails. Yeah, but we'll see. We'll go from there, right? We'll do that. And I did just get a comment about why am I not exporting power? Because I have a rule, no exporting power until 1980. If you look down in the comments or in the description of the video, you'll see. And then the other one I kind of broke a little bit, but I won't overbreak it anymore, is no exporting oil. But it wasn't my intention to say you couldn't buy a biofuel plant and sell off the excess oil. As a matter of fact, I don't even know if we're going to be. Let's just take a look here. Did we even export last month? Soviet? Yeah, a little bit. 11 things. So, I mean, really, what I was trying to do with the no exporting oil is I would have just come straight over to this island, built a refinery, and just exported oil over to here if I just wanted to make a lot of money. Right? I mean, and it really makes it a lot more challenging. Notice the timing. We're supposed to start launching towards this way, right? We're talking about moving back north. Well, guess what? It's 1973. We've gone down here in that time and started building up our, ability to make steel and other things. And then now we're sort of starting to talk about coming back this way and getting. Oh, we got no money. Let's pause. Hopefully we didn't go. It's just a little bit annoying when you have to. Yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and borrow another 1.2 because we didn't get it paid down enough to not. All right, and I don't want it to be too short. Oh, there we go. And then, right. So we're gonna borrow this. Now, how much did we? 3,000. We didn't neglect it too bad. All right, but I'm just gonna pay off the 1,106,478. Oop, 478. All right, so then that pops back to that, and then it should take us back down to $1 or zero. It's sort of like, if you notice, look, this is 303 for some reason, and this says 302. So there's sometimes it gets you down to $1, but that they'll take that money out in an instant. All right, so let's close this. We might have even done it like that quick. No, not quite yet. We'll see it disappear any second. I don't know if it waits for the next day or what the story is. But anyway, so there we go. So we have a rule against oil and a rule against exporting that. And it's just to make the beginning of the map a little bit more challenging. Otherwise, I just find it all too easy. Like, yeah, go export some. I would have come over here, built a, couple power plants and just export as much as you can. And it's fine. I mean, it's play the game how you want. It's not a judgment on anybody else's play style, right? That's just there we go. So that's fully paid off now. Good. It's just I like this, the Harding start challenge, becoming self-sufficient, Like, to me, that's the big fun of this game. Not necessarily just trying to make a bunch of money. I don't find this to be a difficult game to actually make money in now that I've played enough. It's just, you know, there's certain things you can do that are like, I don't want to say OP, but they're like pushing, you know, like financially speaking, they're definitely like very powerful and make the game not so hard. If you don't know what those things are, it's a little bit more of a challenge, but and depending on where you start, again, so if you make some start conditions where oil is further away and that kind of thing, then you certainly, you know, can make it a lot more challenging. Anyway, that was a very long diatribe. Is that the right word? For what we want to do over here. So what I'm thinking of is, and we may end up moving these power lines eventually, right? If we have to. But as I was even sitting there, in the back of my mind, something popped in, and that was, well, let's lay down what we would do here. Now, do we want, I don't think we necessarily need, you know, we need a rail cargo station, right? And yeah, you know, this stuff would fit pretty nicely on the other side of these tracks. Especially if we maybe, yeah, a little bit further down this way, I think. Right, and then the other thing that we're going to want is, and I'm just going to put this here for the sake of aggregate loading, aggregate unloading. Right, and so we probably would want the ability to get some gravel. Well, you know what? We got gravel right over here. Do we want to centralize the gravel? You know what? I'll hold off, but let me just put it in, say, here. What was that message? Right, just as sort of a reminder. Yeah, let's get rid of some of these messages. Did anything burn down? That's usually how I find out something burned down is, and I wasn't getting rid of all of these. Yeah, good, fire extinguished. The Riverville School. Okay, Riverville School is on fire. All right, come on. Come on. Boy, there's a lot of them. Probably just have done this when I... Really? How many more is there? Okay, 3. I guess I can do it. Building is on fire. It looks like it's still there. Right. Good. Okay, so... Yeah, so we'll, I'll leave that there as just sort of as a reminder to what we're going to do. And then again, this is really... I'm thinking I just really want to get one of these regular storages for now going. Maybe the cement thing, but I won't do the cement thing right now. Let's see. Now, I really want to probably come here. All right. So the only things that we're going to have is something like this. Now, do we want the big ones? No. We really probably just want the small ones. All right, and I'm even thinking maybe this one can go like that, right? Now you attach. Yeah. All right, so that, well, this is going to be a, well, let's see. Do we want to do each of these? All right, so let's, okay, good. We can get to the small here. Right, and this one, I think, well, let's put the road in. At some point, we need to really consider. Yeah, let's go back to, like, here. All right, and then we can, that'll help us line. Yeah, I'm thinking we kind of line this guy up that way, right? Kind of nice if we could do that, but maybe not. Yeah, let's just reconnect. Yeah. At some point, we need to switch over to building the other roads, right? So then what we'll do is... Yeah, do we come around this way? Because this would be like bricks, and then this could be steel, and like it's really, I found in the past, like we don't necessarily need one for each. Certainly not for like where that we're gonna build. Like, in other words, let's just look at this again. Like, if we come here and hover, like this will hold. Let's see, where is it? Let's go over to here. Right there. It's a little easier to see. So, like each one of these, we could hold over 100 of each one if we just did two. Does that make sense? So, in other words, if we just, we could hold 160 steel, which is usually really plenty for a train to have to drop off. So I'm thinking I like this, and then we'll get this connected. But then I'm also thinking, what do we do over here? If this is, say, bricks and wood, and yeah, maybe we do our cement over there. We just don't worry about it right now. And I don't see anything. Do we want to keep this road, I guess, closer to here? No. Not particularly. All right, we'll do something like this. All right, and then this can get connected. And then what we could do is have them dropping off, a little bit larger amount here. And then from here, we could either have the construction offices assigned to go out here, or we'll just have like a smaller set of trucks that are designed to keep this full. Like, we could even consider just having like one truck that would constantly drive back and forth and keep this full of all the different things. That would be kind of an interesting. I haven't tried that before. Right? But let's get this going because I think this would be good. We could drop off by train. This could actually head right through. We could talk about putting cement over here in the future. We could also possibly attach like a regular warehouse to this if we got into the mechanical components and electrical components. So let's just, for the sake of some sort of completeness, sort of do this. All right. So that'll have to come in. Good. I like it. So let's commit to all of that and this and that. All right. So when we get, what did I do? Come here. There. All right. So now, how are we doing up here? Are we ready to? Did we get this going? Yeah. We're working on it. Let's see. How are you guys looking? Okay. We got lots of digits flashing by there. So let us. Yeah, I think that's a pretty nice little start to getting at least some kind of distribution by truck going, right? Until we really stabilize. Look at our steel is coming up nicely. And when you talk about fussing, by the way, like, I'm even fussing over building these things, if you want to look at it that way, right? Like, so it's like, because, well, I could really use that steel. Let's get this darn farm built first, which will increase our crops, which will increase our exports here because we're just out of crop. So yeah, good. Look, we almost got enough stone there. And that's another thing. Yeah, we need to get some stone brought down to here. Let's start that process. All right, so I think the thing to do, yeah, I'd really like to get, well, it'd be nice if we could drag the stone down to here eventually, but man, how are we doing? We don't really have a ton of the stuff. And I'm guessing the best thing to do is maybe just to buy another dumper. Do we have the money? Well, who knows? We don't really have the money for anything, but we'll just get. And then the other thing is we eventually get that better. I don't know when, but we eventually get the better dump truck than this. That's my favorite dump truck, I guess you could call it. We'll get one dumper for now. And we'll say your job's going to be to go from here and all the way back to here. And one's fine too, because if for some reason we wait in both places for gravel. All right, so he'll start bringing a little bit down here so we don't completely run out, I hope. Then the other thing is we don't have any truck coming from here anymore. Yeah, it definitely could make some sense to see. This is where the people in Reverville are just a complete waste of time at this point. So what are you? You're the gravel. Yeah, there's no trucks coming into here. Yeah, so let's buy another dump truck. All right, just for the sake of, and then we can have this guy coming from here, bringing it in the other way, right? Ooh, gravel weight, start. Now the problem is they might jam up our whole works here if they both end up sitting there waiting, but that's not a problem until we run out. But we have to keep an eye on that. Okay, good. Well, let me re-catch my thoughts, and then we're going to end the episode. But I'll let a little bit of time flow, and then maybe we can, get a bit of this going. And I have no idea how long the episode is, but yeah, I just want to find that out, and then I might let some time pass just to get like this built, so that we can start distributing some things a little bit more intelligently. All right, see you guys in a minute. Okay, as per usual, we're well over a half hour already. But we did get this one building built, and I thought I would come back and talk about, our loan. We're getting further and further into loan debt. I know we bought some vehicles, but we need to buy a few more, I think. Either that or we have to steal them for our from our construction, which I don't really want to do. So I think we've come in here, and again, it'll be a nice day when we get to the more efficient trucks, but let's see what we can do with this. Yeah, we'll just get, let's see, we're going to do one for each, right? So we got bricks, and we've got prefab panels, and we've got, oops, can I not buy another one? Oh, we don't have enough money. Okay, so let's go over to here. Yeah, so these are getting rather expensive, aren't they? We just don't have, so I'm going to have to up this to 1.3. Oh, right. So we're going to go ahead and borrow that money, and then let's come over here. You know what? Let's pause this because it gets out of sync. I don't want it to be out of sync. Oh yeah, and I didn't pay it back, so I probably got a little bit of a penalty. All right, so 1190334. So we'll return that much money. Close that, and then we should have a little bit more money to at least buy one more of these, right? So I guess we can double click here. All right, so we'll get these set up. Oops, you know what? Time's still paused. That doesn't need to be. All right, so let's play this. So what I want these guys to do, so I want this one for now to come in here and pick up bricks, all right? And then I want you to drop off your bricks right here. Let's make them bricks so you can wait. We don't want them necessarily to wait here. So we're just going to say, okay, I want you to come in here and drop off your bricks. And then I want you to come here, right? Yeah, and unload the rest of your bricks. And really just unload anything at that point, right? Because this, whatever's in here, there's going to be another truck that just sits here constantly and waits. Now, eventually we'll, are you almost done? Well, we're not done this building, but eventually I'll switch them over to this building, right? It'll only be three trucks. Does that make sense? So then I'll have a truck like sitting here or here. We'll have to get another one. So let's start this guy. So he's going to deliver bricks. Really, and this guy's going to have a very similar route, but he's going to come in here and pick up prefab panels. And again, we'll expand this in the next episodes as we get better. And you're going to drop off prefab panels there. You can wait, and don't wait to unload them here. And then I want you to come back and drop off anything extra that you have in you, which will just be the prefab panels into here. And then we'll do the same thing. Okay. Don't start yet. So this guy is going to come into here, and he is going to pick up steel and wait, right? And then you're going to drop off your steel there and don't wait. And then you're going to come back here and drop off anything but steel, ultimately. And you're waiting there. Yeah, we don't really want you to wait here. Just drop it off and get going.
Because if this isn't empty, then we'll deal with that, like, say, next, right? Let's start this guy. And then I think we need one more of these guys. All right, so they should be delivering bricks at least to that one, because that's where we want to build the farm for now. There's going to be a little micromanaging involved. And I am going to purchase one more open hall to show you guys why I'm going through all of this. All right, so then now we have this guy here, and what I want him to do is wait for a load of anything. Right, so I don't care what you have, but make sure you're loaded. And I'm pretty sure this will work out fine, right? And then I want you to come here and unload anything, right? But don't wait. Start. Now again, it might get a little bit hectic and busy if we have trucks running all over the map, so that's why we'll eventually, well, we'll build this right away. But, you know, I think I might have the trucks going out to the export just sitting in here. Then the other ones can come in here and drop off. And then this guy will leave and go. So if he gets a full truckload of anything. Now, do we want to limit? No, we don't want to limit the amount, right? This is just anything that makes it into here is going to be excess that we want to get exported, right? That means wherever we're sending that truck off to is now full of stuff. Like, for example, full of, if we had a boards truck coming here, the boards would then be getting exported, right? But in the meantime, those other things, until we fill this up. And then so once we fill this up and we see things getting exported, I know I can come in here and say, well, maybe I send that truck over to the Reverville one for a little while. Let's fill up Reverville with all the other things, right, besides the boards. And then ultimately we can build our new storage here and we'll have it fill up those. Now, do we make it go through like a chain, or do we have like, you know, separate trucks that we just sort of micromanage depending on where we're doing construction until we can get a train system in where we'll have the train drop off. Did I say whatever train? Yeah. Drop off a bunch of stuff here that can then be trucked further along or whatever the case is. So there we go. So that's the thinking. I hope that is pretty clear as to why I was doing that. Now, are you guys... Yeah, we should probably see what happens with this, but we can get them definitely to work on this road, right? That'll be good to get that connected up, save these guys a little bit of a thing. And then this guy, just so you know, one last thing to look at, and we'll come back in the next episode and see, we have the little export system we can set up for the clothing too, but what is this guy doing? Yeah, I assigned him to start working on this road, so... Hopefully by the time this is full, we can start talking about seeing if we want to move some of these construction vehicles down just for the sake of getting that farming thing done and to get our distribution system worked on. And then we can come back up here as time and money and people and everything else permits and finish building our cement factory and a bunch of these things that are still in yellow. There you go. I hope you guys have enjoyed the episode. I hope you have a wonderful day. Take care of yourselves. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.